Oh my, it's a new year and a new name for hockey in Saginaw. Will a traditional name bring back those traditional winning seasons from yesteryear? Stay tuned and find out as we head back to the future on the series debut of the Saginaw Gears Game of the Week. Hi once again, hockey fans, and welcome to Saginaw Gears Hockey. I'm Dan Waxell. Well, this game tonight is the home opener for the Saginaw Gears, as the Gears will face off against their arch enemy, the Flint General. We'll be back with more.
Hello, hockey fans. Bill Corbier on the set of In the Crease, bringing you the excitement of Saginaw Gears Hockey all season long. Join me and head coach Robert Dirk as we highlight hard-checking, fast-paced action of the Saginaw Gears hockey team. Check out your favorite plays from the Gears games, as well as in-depth looks at the team and organization behind the scenes. That's In the Crease with me, your host Bill Corbier, and head coach Robert Dirk. Sundays at 4:30 on QTV, Delta College Quality Television.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's take you, along with the Saginaw Gears, back to the future. Gentlemen, magician Mark Bellinger will perform for you tonight our very own Back to the Future Miracle on Ice. The healing magic is about to begin. Hand for magician Mark Bellinger, who brought us back to the future and rediscovered the Gears mascot, the Gorilla. And since we went back to the future, he's coming back out of the ice again now in his brand new four-wheeler. Capitalist of Bridgeport Polaris, the Gorilla has his own means of transportation into the 90s. And wearing number two, would you welcome, please, Joe Smazza. Dave Van Drunen. At forward, and your captain, wearing number 10, Pete Osborne. And left wing, he wears number 14, Dominic Chason. Center ice, wearing number 16, Brian Steiner. Left wing, wearing number 18, Trevor Bremner. And left wing for the Gears, number 19, Mark Giannetti. Number 20, Jesse Grenier. And number 21 at defense, Patrick Charbonneau. At center ice, he wears number 22, Francois Sassonville. And right wing, number 24, Mike Senior. And center ice, number 27, Joel Gardner. At defense, number 28, Rick McDonald. And at center, number 29, Justin Morrison. And in goal, number 30, Mark DeLorme. The general manager of the Gears is George Mattias. Their trainer is Jason Wood. Equipment manager is Ray House, and the head coach of the Gears is Robert Dirk. And ladies and gentlemen, the Gears proudly present the Gears Birthday Club, where a lucky birthday child can have a party at each and every Gears home game. And tonight's birthday boy is Jordan Manius. He's 7 years old today. And Captain Keith Osborne will be giving him an autographed pennant. And if you'd like more information on the Kids Birthday Club, simply contact the Gears office. It happens each and every home game right here at the Civic Center. Jordan, our birthday guest tonight, is coming out on the ice, and he's getting that from the Gears captain, Keith Osborne. How about a nice happy birthday to Jordan Manius? Ladies and gentlemen, ice level, turn your attention to Section 7, ice level, please. You too could have a chance to be here each and every home game. Look at our lucky people over there. They're jumping in the hot tub tonight. Compliments of the Bellows. They're in the hot tub, one of the best seats in the building each and every year's home game. A hot tub at ice level, Section 7, compliments of the Bellows. Ladies and gentlemen, here tonight's starting lineups. First of all, for the Flint Generals, at defense number 19, Mike Bondy. At defense number 48, Steve Beadle. Left wing, number 12, Peter Ambrosiak. Right wing for Flint, number 42, Ross Wilson. Center ice, number 8, Brian Sackey. And in goal, number 33, Rob Lurie. Head coach of the Flint Generals is Larry Floyd. Ladies and gentlemen, your starting lineup tonight for your Saginaw Gears. Starting in defense and wearing number 4, Brian Mueller. At defense, number 21, Patrick Charbonneau. And in goal, number 10, Marquis Delore. The officials working tonight's hockey game, the linesman are Ross Sisko, Brian Marshall. Our referee tonight is George Harrison. Now, ladies and gentlemen, our colors are being presented on the ice tonight by Bravo Company, 1st of the 125th Infantry. And at this time, we'd like you all to stand and join with our guest vocalist this evening, Ms. Tina Cook, the singing of our national anthem.
Again, hockey fans, and welcome to Saginaw Gears Hockey. We'll get this game underway yet. Well, at Quad City in Asheville, delayed due to a 30-minute pregame. I think we beat that, though, I think. By about 15, 20 minutes, haven't we, Chip? Chip just came up here and Henry says that their game is being delayed, too. And I thought, oh, my gosh, I'm getting tired out. We haven't even dropped the puck yet. Well, we'll get this underway. Well, Guts getting ready to rumble. Let's see what happened. Justin Morrison. Well, now Morrison goes on the right side, and Francois Sassaville takes the draw, and the Gears' first home opener of the 1998-99 season underway. Puck fired in, deep in the right corner in the Saginaw zone. Mueller plays it around the boards up on the right side. Sackey, centering pass loose at the side of the goal. Delorme knocks it into the corner. Ross Wilson plays it in the corner, but he put it right on the stick that time.
of Sassaville who gets it back to center. Generals quickly slide the puck back into the gear zone.
DeLorme out of his net, puts it off the right glass and back to the Flint blue line.
Now Bondi, his pass knocked down. Gardner, he's ridden off the puck by Mike Bondi, picked up by Nemorowski. He lost it.
There's Gardner in across the Flint line, trying to go around his man. Here's Osborne, picks it up straight, puts it out front, picks it up in the left corner though. Along the left wing board. Osborne plays it down deep into the corner. Chase on. Here's a shot by Van Gunen right on. And the save made. Loose out in the slot. And in turn, Chad Bill picks it up for Flint and clears it down ice. Oh, Rob Morey had to come up with a save here. And the opening minute and a half of this first period. Now Bergen across the line, going right to the net, but it's whistled down on the offside. Well, much to the dismay of the fans, as Joel Gardner trying to stick it over to get around the Flint player, and that results in the offside, 18-47. Left here in the opening period, no score. And the Saginaw Gears so far with the only shot on goal.
Joel Gardner setting the line with Mark Gianetti on one side, Dominic Chiasson on the right. On the faceoff, the Generals control in their own end. Crosslice pass up to Nemorowski on the right wing. Knocked off his stick by Jamie Hayden. Nemorowski picks it up again, fires it deep into the Saginaw zone. DeLorme out of his net. Up on the right side to Chiasson. Over to Gianetti, jumped over his stick, but Gardner picks it up, dumps it deep in the Flint zone.
Rob Lorry, the goaltender, plays it behind his goal. Here's Jeff Little on left wing. Little down the left wing board, rolls it deep into the Saginaw end as the Generals go for a line change.
DeLorme again banks it off the right wing boards, comes back to center. Gardner, who's been out here a long time, this time put it right on the stick of Ward, and Dwayne Ward fires it deep into the Saginaw end. As the Generals are able to complete their line change, brother DeBeers and Generals, both fresh troops out there.
Now in turn, here's Brian Steiner.
Steiner had trouble with it. Leaves it there now for Rick McDonald. McDonald, the defenseman, nice little outlet pass. There in turn is Mike Senior, fires it right on the goaltender, Rob Lorry, knocks it down. Bremer in there with a run at his man. Smaza on the left point, holds it in. Now in turn, the Generals get it back to the neutral zone. And the Gears fire it right back in. Now Mike Bondi on up to Dwayne Ward. Ward, a little outlet pass, racing after it. And across the line, taking off the stick of O'Brien. Nice defensive play by Brian Mueller.
Now the Gears have it in behind the goal. Patrick Charbonneau.
Pass comes back to center here. Sassaville, Francois Sassaville, a shot right on.
And Rob Lorry caught that in the midsection. Seen that one all the way and holds on. 16:55 left here in the first period. No score. Let's pause for this. This is Saginaw Gears Hockey on Sports Talk Radio. Now, welcome back, and 16:23 left here in the first period.
No score.
Nothing, no penalties or anything else happening either.
Play at center ice, Joel Gardner for the Gears up on left wing to Gianetti. Mark Gianetti gives it on off here. Here's Chiasson, lost it, here's Gianetti shot!
And that time, Rob Lorry just got a piece of it, deflected over the top of the goal.
They still battle in the Flint zone. Gardner in the left corner. Gardner back to Chiasson, trying to get around his man, but he was taken off the puck by Chad Grills.
And here comes the Generals back up ice. Nemorowski in across the line.
Good poke check that time by Dave Van Drunen.
comes back on the point, though. Beetle shot right on. Another shot and another save by Mark DeLore.
At that time, Steve Beetle let the shot go. Here's Beetle again, and we've got our first penalty coming up of the game. A hooking call is coming up as referee George Harrison has called the first penalty of the hockey game, and it's going against the Flint Generals as Mikhail Nemirovsky goes off for hooking. And so the Saginaw Gears will go to the power play, their first power play of the night. On the faceoff, Brian Mueller, who quarterbacks the power play, takes it in behind his goal. Now pass up on the near boards. Here's Van Drunen at center. His pass too far out in front of Dominic Chason. And in turn, Steve Beetle just fires it back deep into the gear zone. The Gears go back and regroup on the power play.
A minute 35 left in the penalty to Mikhail Nemirovsky.
Now Brian Mueller at center. His pass knocked down. Gets it again. Gears roll it into the Flint zone, but Steve Beetle picks it up.
And once again, fires it back down ice, and the Gears go back and regroup. DeLorm gives it off to Dave Van Drunen.
Van Drunen at his own blue line. Down the right wing boards, fires it in, but he put it right on the stick that time of Mike Bondy, who finds an opening and throws it all the way down ice. Mark DeLorm gives it off to Brian Mueller.
To the captain, Keith Osborne. Osborne being watched by Whittle, gives it off and behind a goal.
Now Joel Gardner up on left wing. Dave Van Drunen cross ice, pass to Mueller. Now Mueller rifles it deep into the Flint zone, came off the boards out in front, racing after it. Justin Morrison, a centering pass knocked down as Gardner tried to get it out front, and a good job by Beetle. Knocked that down, and Flint clears it all the way down ice.
42 seconds left in the power play for the Gears. 14:20 left here in the opening period. It's scoreless.
Now in turn and across the line, Morrison for the Gears. Gives it back to Gardner along the blue line. Joel Gardner at the side of the net, knocked away that time from Giannetti, back on the right point. Nashville over to McDonald, wind up a shot! And that time just went wide. I think maybe Bob Loy got a piece of it.
McDonald on the right point. Patrick Charbonneau shot that deflects off a stick and up into the crowd and out of play. Oh, my.
Here's getting that puck movement on the power play. Trying to utilize the point, Patrick Charbonneau.
Wound up, let the shot go, but a Flint player got a stick on it and deflected it high up into the crowd and out of play. 13:54 left here in the first period, 14 seconds. Still left in the power play for the Saginaw Gears. Brian Steiner, Mike Senior, and Jesse Grenier, the forward unit out there now for the Saginaw Gears. Jamie Hayden and Joe Smaza paired together back on the point. On the faceoff, the Generals win it. Mike Bondy in the corner, finds an opening, clears it all the way down ice. That'll probably eat up the rest of the power play time for the Gears. Jamie Hayden plays it in behind his goal. Comes out on himself on the right side, up to Joe Smaza at center. Here is Senior in across the line, and it's knocked off his stick. And in turn, Bondy trying to clear it, bounces the blue line. Now here is Nemirovsky, who's out of the box.
Nemirovsky to Whittle, who throws it down deep into the right corner in the Flint zone. Both teams back to full strength. Bondy out in front, shot by Whittle, great save!
By Mark DeLorme, robbing Whittle right on the doorstep. How by, great save by Mark DeLorme.
As Jeff Whittle, right at the hash marks unloaded. Jeff Whittle and Mike Senior at center ice are joined with another. And now Jeff Whittle drops the glove. And in turn, Jesse Grenier and Mike Bondy and Mike Senior and Jeff Whittle are throwing punches. We got two fights going at the same time.
Jeff Whittle and Mike Senior
and Jesse Grenier and Mike Bondy. And I'll tell you what, a good job by Jesse Grenier and Mike Bondy
just to say, okay, that's enough. The linesmen were busy
with Jeff Whittle and Mike Senior, so we've got more penalties here.
Well, I'll tell you what, I don't know what happened. Jeff Whittle coming back up ice.
Him and Mike Senior were jawing with one another.
13:04 left here in the first period. Saginaw 0, Flint 0. Let's pause for this. This is Saginaw Gears Hockey on Sports Talk Radio.
You want the 2 and the 5 up?
We'll find out what the official call is here as soon as we get it.
Five and inside two on this.
Well, the Saginaw Gears on their power play.
There's 2 minutes roughing, 5 minutes fighting, and a 10-minute misconduct. The number 24, Mike Senior, 2 minutes roughing. The penalties at 6 minutes and 56 seconds of the first period.
Well, there we have it. Jeff Whittle gets, I'll tell you what, he had 2 minutes for roughing. He got five for fighting. And a 10-minute misconduct. Mike Senior just gets 2 minutes for roughing, and likewise, Jesse Grenier gets 2 minutes for roughing. All these coming at 6:56. And here we go back to play. Flint in behind their goal. Now Beadle out in front of his net. Little outlet pass to Sakic through the neutral zone on the right side, cutting the net. That time was Ambrosiak. He's knocked to the ice in behind the goal, and a good job by Mueller. Now in turn, the Gears start back up. Ice, Patrick Charbonneau over to Osborne and across the line. Unloads a shot over top of the goal. Lands on the backside of the net. They battle for it. It is kicked loose, and George Harrison blows the whistle. I'll tell you what, quickly, if you ask me, we've seen this happen up in Thunder Bay. And that puck laid on the backside of the net for about 7 or 8 seconds before Jason Payne knocked it off the net and put it in the goal when everyone just stopped and looked at one another. They counted that one a goal, but George Harrison quickly blew this one down, and faceoff will come outside the Flint zone because it was fired by a Saginaw player and landed on the backside of the net. Well, 4:27 left in the penalty to Jeff Whittle, a minute 27 left in the penalty to the Gears. So it's 4-on-4 hockey with 12:25 left here in the first period. There's a shot! Oh, and that time Laurie just got a glove on that one, deflected it over. 4,307 is our attendance here tonight. My, great. Now here's the Gears back in their own end. Dominic Chase on outlet pass. Mandrunen across the line, fakes the shot, goes in the right corner. Mandrunen avoids a check. Getting in there now, trying to help out is Justin Morrison. Morrison again with it, back on the right point. Played by McDonald. McDonald throws it in behind the Flint goal. Knocked down by goaltender Rob Laurie. Oh, it jumped over the stick that time of Rick McDonald and slides back into the Gears zone. Now in turn, here's Dominic Chason for the Gears in his own end. Pass up on left wing. Patrick Charbonneau in across the line. Charbonneau, stick handles, tried to throw it out in front. He's knocked down, able to steer deeper into the corner. Now in turn, here's Greg Kushkin. First time we've seen him out there tonight for Flint, throws it down ice. Now here comes the Gears once more back in. Neutral zone knocked away. Charbonneau has to race back into his own end, being watched by Chad Grill. Grill turns off. Charbonneau comes to center. Here's Mueller. Brian Mueller, stick handles in across the line. Hit it slide off his stick. Chases it down in the corner. Knocked away from him, but Osborne picks it up. He tried to center it. Knocked away. Now in turn, a shot right out by Francois Sasseville. And Laurie had to make the save. Mueller back on the left point to Gardner. Over on the right point, Van Drunen throws it down. Out in front. Oh, and a chuck over the stick. A shot. Oh, that's knocked away by Laurie. Off to the right was Osborne. Now in turn, Gardner back to Mueller. His shot tipped wide as it hit the stick of Nemirovsky. And Nemirovsky picks it up, gets back to center. Here's Grills. Get across the line. Good poke check by Mueller. Van Drunen dumps Grills to the ice. Play goes on as the Saginaw Gears again have a man in Danny. And across the line, Gardner knocked off his stick. Goes right to goaltender Mark DeLorme. Now to Rick McDonald, who gives it off in the corner of Van Drunen. Quickly headmans a puck up the center to Osborne, gives it back to Van Drunen. Van Drunen across the center red line, dumps it in.
Chasing in after it, Joel Gardner. Make that Sasseville rather. And it's cleared again by Flint.
Saginaw Gears having trouble trying to set it up on the power play. They need to try to get it in the Flint zone, slow it down.
9:55 left here in the first period. 0-0 is our score. 1:45 left the power play for the Gears. But the Generals have it at center. Now in turn, here's McDonald. He rifles it in off the left wing boards.
Bob Lloyd, the goaltender, behind his net. Ran into his own man. Kept him to the point. By Patrick Charbonneau on the left point to McDonald. McDonald throws it down. That went off the stick of Brian Sackett, but into the corner.
Here's still control. Justin Morrison with it. In the slot, knocked away from Gardner. Good job by McDonald to hold it in, but he tried to play to the right point,
and it squirts back to center. Now here's a 2-on-1 break for the Generals. Sackett. Now they jump into the stick of Ambrosiak. Actually, the pass was in behind him.
Oh, big break for the Gears that time is. Two Generals cutting in. Sackett and Ambrosiak. Now here's Gardner's shot. Saved by Rob Lourdes. He looked behind him.
Oh, a golden chance for that time, Joel Gardner. And Rob Lloyd dropped out. He looked behind him, but he had it underneath him. Oh, that was close. 9:07 left here in the first period. We're scoreless. Let's pause for this. This is Saginaw Gears Hockey on Sports Talk Radio.
Now the Gears on the power play, right out in front. That skipped over the stick of Dominic Chason. Still 45 seconds of power play for the Gears. Now the pass is intercepted, and Steve Beadle finds an opening, clears it down ice, and the Gears go back and regroup.
Gears so far with three shots
on their power play. Here's Brian Mueller in behind his goal. Pass up on the near boards. Van Drunen gives it back to Mueller. Throws it up the center ice to Sasseville. Sasseville and across the Generals line. Here's Sasseville, shot right on.
Corey makes a save. The rebound is loose at the side of the net. Francois Sasseville knocked down.
Play still in the Flint zone along the far board. They battle for it. O'Brien had it knocked away from him. Now Mueller pinches in from the left point. Racking at a Steve Beadle. Ross Wilson picks it up for Flint. Clears it back to center ice, and it bounces all the way down ice back into the Gears zone. The warm leads to the side of the net for Van Drunen. Now both teams are back to full strength. Pass jumped over the stick too far. Brian Steiner comes back in the Flint end. And the Generals control. Nemorowski, the Grills, who tips it deep into the gear zone. Racing after Joe Spazza. He stepped in too. Out in front, loose in the slot. Bouncing. Here's Grills. Had it knocked off his stick. Grills again with it. Trying to center it. And in turn, the Gears come up with it. Brian Steiner over to the captain. Keith Osborne, Lex the right, let it in. Oh, he hit that time. Dobnik. Now Jones comes back to center, and Bremner fires it right back in. 7:25 left here in the opening period. 0-0, 4,307 here tonight at the Civic Center. Standing off to my right, Robbie Nichols. I know he's got to be pleased with that. Puck comes back deep into the gear zone. Jamie Hayden takes a run at his man. Loose puck. Trying to come in after Mike Senior. Puck goes in behind the goal. Nemorowski has it. His shot never got through. And Brundrum backhands it off the boards and back to the neutral zone. Now in turn, Pollock fires it right back in. Bounces off the side of the goal. And here we go. Trevor Brundrum for the Saginaw Gears. And I believe it's a Dobnik going, and they end up right into the Flint bench as the gate came open. Dobnik, Jeremy Dobnik trying to get the hand free. Jesse Grenier also trying to get the arm free, and now the linesman quickly intervened and break up this one. Oh, I'll tell you what, they ended up in the penalty box. That was Trevor Brumner for the Gears, as you say. Dobnik,
and they'll both go to the block. Well, 6:55 left here in the first period. It's 0-0. Let's pause for this. This is Saginaw Gears Hockey on Sports Talk Radio. We'll be right back.
Well, 6:55 left here in this first period as Trevor Bremner of the Gears and Jeremy Sladovnik go off. Each 5 minutes for fighting, face off in the Gears zone. Mike Bondi, his shot goes in behind the goal, picked up by Jamie Hayden. Hayden backhands it up on the right wing boards, cleared out by Dominic Chason. Back to center ice, Gardner had to go off his skate. Hayden picks it up again, trying to get it back to Gardner. Gardner able to dump it deep into the Flint zone. Rob Lurie plays it in behind his goal. Bounces over right from Mike Bondi. Long turn up on the left side for Ward, jumped over his stick. Now in across the line, a shot that time by Corey Ingles, who first time we've seen him out there tonight. Knocked away and is cleared back to center. Now here comes the Gears back. Here's Dominic Chase on the right side. His shot and a save! That time by Rob Lurie, he got the stick on that one. Deflection high up into the crowd. And out of play, a 2-on-1 break that time for the Gears. And Dominic Chason, who has that very much indeed a heavy shot, unloaded just inside the right circle. And that time, Rob Lurie able to get a stick on it and deflect it up into the crowd. 6:14 left here in the opening period. These same two teams will play each other 14 times during the course of the regular season. And I think very much indeed the I-75 rivalry will be back with a great intensity and maybe even a hatred for each other before the season is done. Play right back into the Flint zone. Puck slides back to the neutral ice area, raced after Mueller, trying to go right to the net. Here's Sackett again, a shot, and he fired it wide. On the stick side as Sackett was in. Now to play at center, here's Ross Wilson. And the Generals gives it off to Ambrosiak in a circle, trying to throw it out in front. Good job by Mueller, staying with him. Now in turn, trying to clear it that time with Justin Morrison, but it's kept in. Back on the point, jumped that time, came over the stick of Greg Kushkin, and he fires it back in and whistles down on the outside. I'll tell you, 0-0 with 5:25 left here in the first period. Now here comes the Gears trying to come up out of their own end. Slides back to center. Now Collicutt giving a rough ride. Osborne in there trying to get it. Gears trying to make a change. Now in turn, Mark Collicutt, his pass went behind his man. Comes back into the Gears zone, and Saginaw starts back on fight. Van Drunen, his shot from center ice right on. Rob Lurie had no problem with that one, knocks it down. Now in turn, the puck cleared, comes back to center. Patrick Charbonneau at his own blue line for the Gears. To Jamie Hayden, back in the road end. Back over to Patrick Charbonneau. He gives it on up to Joel Gardner. Gardner, down the left wing boards, gains the line. Got it back to Giannetti, throws it in the right wing corner. Gardner back after it, but it's played away from him, and it comes back to center. Charbonneau now, lost control of it. Chad Grill picks it up, fires it right on. DeLorme knocks it down. Charbonneau picks it up, banks it off the boards, back to center to Gardner. And here's Giannetti, one man back. Giannetti in, had it knocked off his stick, tried to go back for it. Now it's picked up by Mikhail Nemirovsky. Nemirovsky starting up out of his own end. Stolen by Gardner. Joel Gardner. And he put it right back on the stick of Nemirovsky, who turns and comes back up high. On left wing. Down across the line, O'Brien's shot that deflected off a stick goes wide. And in turn, the Gears elect just to clear it back to center right. Now it comes right back in the Gear zone. Hayden, cross ice pass to Rick McDonald. Trying to get it to Gardner, too far out in front of him. Comes into the Flint zone. Gardner will have to clear the zone, and offside will be the call. 3:52 left here in the first period, 0-0. Now DeLorme way out of his goal, banks it off the boards. Now the Gears turn it back up high. Here's Steiner in across the line. Brian Steiner trying to go around his man, throws a shot right on. And Rob Lurie had to be alert on that one to kick it away. Now trying to keep it into the point with Joe Smaza, but it gets away from him and comes back into the Gears end where Rick McDonald has it. Being watched by Corey Ignis. Banks it off the boards. That comes all the way down ice. And icing will be the call against the Saginaw here. 3:21 left here in the first period. It's 0-0. Let's pause for this. This is Saginaw Gears Hockey on Sports Talk Radio. Well, 3:07 left here in the first period. Play back in the gear zone. Little outlet pass. Now the gears bring it up ice. Here's Steiner in across the line. Jamie Hayding cut to the net. The senior picks it up. Snaps the shot. That never got through. Now in turn is cleared back out. And that center ice knocked down. That time was Craig O'Brien. And the referee, George Harrison, is calling this one. And so Saginaw will be shorthanded as Jesse Grenier heads to the box. And so the Foot Generals will have the power play, their first of the night. 17-13, the time of the penalty to Jesse Grenier. 2 minutes for tripping is the call by referee George Harrison.
Well, here comes the play back into the gear zone. Francois Sasseville makes it all the way down ice, but it's whistled down. And that'll bring the faceoff back deep, intentional offsides against the Flint Generals.
So that'll bring the faceoff back deep into the Flint zone. 1:49 left in the penalty to Jesse Grenier.
2:36 left here in the first period.
0-0 is our score, and so far, I tell you what, Rob Lowry, the busiest of the two goaltenders,
as he come up with some great saves. Now Brian Miller at his own blue line. Francois Sasseville gives it back over to Keith Osborne as the gears are shorthanded. Osborne just looks up, finds an opening, throws it back deep into the Flint end. Rob Lowry leads it in behind his goal. 1:30 left in the penalty to Jesse Grenier. Now in turn across the line. Bondi had to pull up, throws it around the boards. Ross Wilson jumped over his stick. Back on the point, and a good job by Captain Keith Osborne to throw it back down ice, forcing the Generals to regroup on their power play. Exactly 2 minutes left in the first period, 0-0. Over 4,000 fans here tonight, 4,307 to be exact. And across the line, here's Ambrosiak cutting the net, loose in the slot, bouncing around, and Van Drunen picks it up and clears it off the boards back to center.
Ah, good defensive work by the Saginaw Gears. Helping out goaltender Mark DeLorme.
Now Sakic has it up on the left side. Fired in by Mike Bondi. Comes off the corner board. Trying to clear it out that time. Was Justin Morrison. Morrison spins and he's able to backhand it. Back to center ice.
Morrison picks it up again. He'll skate back into his own end. Trying to rag some more time off that penalty to Jesse Grenier.
Puck comes now back deep into the Flint zone.
Now in turn, Steve Beadle.
An outlet pass, Chad Grills down the left wing. Met right there at the blue line, knocked away. Gardner had trouble with it. Now in turn, Ward brings it across the line.
Dwayne Willard being tied up by Van Drunen. Grills stepped in too by Gardner.
Puck goes in behind a goal. Knocked away. That time from O'Brien in the corner. Here's a shot out in front. Loose and tall somehow. Mark DeLorme able to get pads together as Chad Grills off to the left side of the net.
I think Grills was tied up just enough by Dave Van Drunen where he couldn't get that shot away, but the puck laid there, and Mark DeLorme did a good job. I'll tell you what, last season, I guess it was the home opener, right? The average last season was 2,037. That's stretching it, I'm gonna tell you that. Now tonight, 420 short of a sellout. Well, here we go. Face off to the right of Mark DeLorme. Still 3 seconds.
Now Jesse Grenier comes out of the box. Both teams are back to full strength. Good job by the Gears.
Killing off that power play by Flint. 40 seconds left in the first period.
It's 0-0. Play at center ice. Charbonneau. New Gardner and across the line. Chason.
Chason had it caught up in his skates. Gets it off in the corner. Gardner, oh, it jumped that time over the stick. As cutting in was Giannetti.
Way comes right back in. Oh, good hit by Van Drunen on Chad Grill. He rides him heavily into the board. Points a check by Grills, gets it back to center.
Ambrosiak plays it back into his own end. To Mark Collicutt.
Puck comes back into the gear zone. Puck lays there. Now Van Drunen picks it up and turns back up ice. To Gardner in across the line. Back to Van Drunen. Checked off the puck. Jason shot right out as a horn sounds.
Ending this first period, and after 20 minutes of play, it's Saginaw 0, Flint 0. We'll be back to recap this first period for you, but first, let's pause for this. This is Saginaw Gears Hockey on Sports Talk Radio.
Do is make sure the accurate starting or the accurate lineups for both teams dressed gets to Bill Corbier. You know Bill?
Yeah.
Okay. Who does the PA announcements so we can introduce the players as they come out.
During a game, I'm making sure that everybody is doing what they're supposed to be doing. I have a director of media and public relations, director of broadcasting. I've got a PA announcer who I have to keep an eye on. It's a long list. Got merchandise that we have to sell, a couple interns, the box office that sells the tickets. I can go on forever.
Looks good, Marty. We'll start announcing it down at the, probably we'll give it away at the beginning of the third period, so I'll come up and get you when it's time, okay?
As the general manager of the team, my responsibilities come to running the actual day-to-day operations and the business side of the hockey team.
One thing that is really key is, too, is getting them off there as quickly as possible to get them and making sure that you get that puck to Bill Corbier as quickly as you can to determine who the winner is, okay?
Realistically, from the business standpoint, it's more dollars and cents and the bottom line and making sure that your business / professional sports team is a success in the bottom line and that you are making money.
At the Saginaw Gears box office. And then I want you also please mention about Pegasus. We're giving away, again, we'll do the drawing again. You know about that? We'll do that at the beginning of the third period, okay?
From a front office point of view, I think we're moving in the right direction. We've got a good coach, got a good general manager, we got the right people. We got Danny Waxell as our broadcaster. We've got Melissa Wilson as our ticket manager and office manager. We've got myself. Big key is going to be the product on ice. If you don't put a product on ice that's not going to win, we're not going to go anywhere.
Well, I'll tell you what, just like a player, you've got the same thing you're trying to accomplish, and that is to get everything set for the regular season, work out all the bugs. It's a lot of preparation involved, and you get excited about it, though.
Don't worry about starters. You can announce the starters when they get out there.
Right.
Everybody numerically.
This is the way they're lined up.
Yep.
You got it.
All right, my man. Are they lined up numerically?
Yeah.
Then you're in there, baby.
Realistically, it's not a job. When you can tie in your career and your hobby together, it's not a job. It just makes it all that much more fun. And I'd have to say I probably have one of the best jobs there is out there. To be a general manager of a professional sports team is just a dream come true.
1995.
The year of the gears, baby. Don't you got a job to do? Get on air.
Well, welcome back to the Saginaw Civic Center. Having some more difficulties up here, but we'll get it going. Seem to be having some interference a little bit, but we'll get that straightened out as both teams have made their way out into the ice for second period action. In case you just joined us, it's 0-0 after 20 minutes of play. Referee George Harrison as he gets that center ice. And referee ready to drop the puck. And here we go, second period action underway. Ryan Mueller off the left wing boards. Osborne back into deep into the Flint zone. Back after it, played by Beadle, got away from him. Ross Wilson picks it up for the Generals, goes in behind his goal, throws it off in the corner. Quickly getting out is Ambrosiak. Oh, good poke check up that time by Osborne. And Ambrosiak picks it up once more. This throws it back to center, and Ambrosiak, he's knocked down a tripping call. Coming up against the Saginaw Gears here in the second period to start the period. As the referee, George Harrison, calling dripping. As Francois Sasseville head to the box to be the second power play of the night for the Flint Generals. And so Sasseville off for 2 minutes. Just 25 seconds into the second period. 0-0 is the score, in case you just joined us. That'll be the face-off. Just inside, in fact, Ambrosiak kind of flexing that knee a little bit after taking a hit by Francois Sasseville.
But Peter Ambrosiak around the leg, referee George Harrison right there.
Two minutes for tripping. Looking across the way, Jeff Whittle still in the penalty box. He was given 2 minutes of roughing, 5 for fighting, and a 10-minute misconduct. in that first period. Now here back to play, Brian Mueller at his own blue line, trying to bank it off the left glass, goes over the glass and out of play. Minute 54 left in the penalty room, Francois Sasseville, 19-29. Left here in this the second period, 0-0 is our score. Well, face off now just outside the Flint, the Saginaw blue line. Brian Steiner against Sakic. Sakic wins the draw. Dino rifles it off the right wing boards. Bounces off the back of the goal. Mark DeLorme didn't see it. Now another clearing attempt. That finds itself over the glass as Brian Mueller trying to clear the zone. And so that'll bring the face off back deeper into the Saginaw end. Now the Saginaw Gears will go at it again Friday night right here at the Saginaw Civic Center as they take on the BC Icemen. On the faceoff, Osborne able to backhand it all the way down ice, forcing the Generals back in the power play. Now in turn, here is Nemirovsky, fires it deep into the Saginaw end. Sakic picks it up, goes behind the goal, centers out in front to Nemirovsky. He couldn't get the shot away, has it again, back on the point to Beadle. Along the right wing boards to Mikhail Nemirovsky, into the corner to Sakic. Back to Nemirovsky, back on the point. Beadle snapped the shot, that deflected wide. As Ross Wilson on the doorstep, being watched by Patrick Charbonneau. And the Gears clear it back to center. Now Beadle at his own blue line. Here is Beadle. Trying to get it off to Wilson, slides away from him, chasing it down deep in the Saginaw zone. Gives time for Keith Osborne to find an opening and clear it down ice. 45 seconds left in the penalty to Francois Sasseville. 0-0 is our score with 8:15 left here in the second. Now O'Brien in across the line. O'Brien trying to run his man, snapped the shot that went wide on the short side. Kept in by Chad Grill. Back on the point to Bundy. Down into the corner, out in front, knocked away by DeLorme. Now in turn, Beadle let the shot go, and it went right on the stick of Jamie Hayden. Now trying to clearing attempt, that goes out of play. We got a lot of pucks flying over the glass and out of play here tonight. 21 seconds left for the Saginaw Gears to kill off. On this, the Flint Generals power play. Flint and Saginaw will play each other 14 times during the course of a regular season. Well, Chad Grills will take the draw against Justin Morrison back on the point. Now in turn, trying to keep it in was Gray Kushkin down in the corner. They battle for it, tied up. Now in turn, Justin Morrison able to bank it off the boards and get it back. Gray Kushkin all the way down ice. Now in turn, O'Brien, his pass goes astray. Grills picks it up. Oh, big hit that time! By Bremner. Oh, Bremner, really? Level Chad Grills with a check. And I'll tell you what, Sadovnik coming off the bench, I don't know why, to me it was a clean check. Chad Grills had his head down, trying to come across the Saginaw blue line, and Trevor Bremner just put a shoulder into him. Now, big hit, and Chad Grills a little slow getting up. Well, 17:31, big crowd on hand tonight, 4,307. And Chad Grills being helped up now and to the bench. Well, I'll tell you what, he's got a towel being held to his face. I don't know if he got cut or what. And referee George Harrison has not called a penalty on the play. It was a clean hit. Chad Grills just had his head down and got leveled. Well, let's see what kind of developed from this. I don't know. Sadovnik came off of the bench, but I think he was just going to his fallen player, Chad Grill. Well, Joel Gardner, center line with Mark Gianetti on the left side, Dominic Chason on the right. On the faceoff, the puck squirts back into the Saginaw zone. Gray Kushkin has it. Trying to get it out over to Sakic, who just back hands it to center. Now in turn, Joe Smaza fires it back in, knocked down. Now along the near boards. That time stepped into Ambrosiak. out in front. Oh, and jumped over the stick of Joel Gardner after being set up that time by Gianetti. Now the Generals start back. Down the left wing, Peter Ambrosiak goes in the left corner. Centering tip. That skipped through. Back on the point now to Greg Kushkin. Greg Kushkin down deeper into the corner to Sackett. Sackett now over to Wilson. Back on the point to Greg Kushkin. Has trouble with it, being watched by Gianetti. Now Delorme at the side of his goal, wraps it around the boards. Jumped over the stick of Mark Qualicut. And across the line, here's Gardner going to the net. Gardner still has it. Over to shot, score! Dominic Kishaw being set up by Joel Gardner. And the Gears lead 1-0. Oh, lovely. Dominic Chiasson getting his first goal in a Saginaw Years uniform. Joel Gardner put a perfect pass right on the stick of Dominic Chiasson. 3 minutes, 20 seconds here into the second period. It's 1-0 in favor of the Gears. Now back to play. Mike Bondi up on the right side, knocked away and across the line. A shot by Corey Ignis. That just goes wide. And a big hit that time on Mike Bondi as he's knocked to the ice. Needle from the point. His shot right on. Delorme steers it in the corner. Now Dave Van Drunen has lost his helmet around the boards up to Trevor Bremner. Bremner being worked over by Dwayne Ward. And in turn, Bremner falls down on top of the puck. And we get a whistle. 16-16 left here in the second. Saginaw 1, Flint nothing. Let's pause for this. This is Saginaw Gears Hockey on Sports Talk Radio. And we're back, and here we go.
Right in front of this hit goal, we got pushing through seven. Jesse Grenier and Dwayne Ward. They got a tight grip. Trevor Bremner trying to throw punches.
And one of the players in behind the net set is Jeremy Sadovnik. And Bremner trying to get his arm free. Sadovnik throws Bremner down. They're back up. We've got a fight out in front. And Jesse Grenier has a tight grip on Ward. And now the linesman break up the fight in the corner. Trevor Bremner doing a good job of holding his ground with Jeremy Sadovnik. Elbows go to the box, and Jesse Grenier and Dwayne Ward out in front. Well, Dominic Chiasson getting his first goal. Joel Gardner and Mark Delorme, the goaltender, get the assist. Time of the goal, 3:20. And we have referee George Harrison over to the scorer's table. Well, we figured this might happen. I hope we're not going to be in for too much of a long night because we had a long time trying to get this hockey game underway. As Jeremy Sadovnik will go off for the Flint Generals. Trevor Bremner will go off for Saginaw. 4:05, the time when this all broke out. We just got back from our break, and the Gears had to play right in front of the Flint goal, and everything broke loose. Keith Osborne, the captain of the Gears over there. We'll get the announcement on, get this all straightened out to see what happens here. Now Jesse Grenier, he's also in the box for Saginaw. Well, Jesse Grenier might have been given a, I don't know, he might have been given a game misconduct because he's going to the dressing room. Look across the way. Here's the announcement.
All straightened out here. In three games, Dominic Chason has two assists and a goal. And we figured Dominic Chason was going to be the scoring type, and he was set up perfectly on that one. Jeremy Slodobnik and Trevor Bremner both get 5 minutes for fighting, as they were the original fight that started. And then Jesse Grenier get five for fighting and a misconduct. Well, back to play. We'll get it passed to you along as soon as we can. Patrick Charbonneau on the right point. Had it knocked away. Here's Sackey. Sackey on the right wing to Wilson. Comes back in the Saginaw zone. Picked up by Heath Osborne. Osborne forced in behind his goal. Pass up on the near board. Charbonneau, little outlet pass. Justin Morrison put it right on the stick that time of Mike Bondi. Bondi pulls up in the corner. Deep in the Flint zone, Ambrosiak had it knocked down. Now internal outlet pass, here's a two-on-one break. Sackey and Wilson, over to Wilson. Snap the shot, saved by DeLord. As DeLord came out and cut the angle down. As Flint had a two-on-one break. Now back right into the Flint zone. Here's Osborne going to the net. Osborne trying to get away from Sackey. Back on the left point. Jamie Hayden throws it down, a tip shot. And that goes off the stick. Now Francois Sassaville over the glass and on a play. 14:57 left here in the second period. Hastings just joined us. Saginaw 1, Flint nothing. Dominic Chason getting the goal. Joel Gardner, Mark DeLorme. DeLorme got the puck up to Joel Gardner, who brought it into the Flint zone and passed it out in front. Dominic Chason off to the right side of the goal had all kinds of room. Play back at center. Now O'Brien chases it down in the Saginaw end. Craig O'Brien bumped off the puck by Jamie Hayden. Van Drunen picks it up, backhands it back to center. Now in turn, played by Greg Kushkin. Knocked away, puck comes back deep into the Saginaw end. Mark DeLorme backhands it around the boards. Now Giannetti, a little outlet pass. Here's Dominic Chason, who has the goal. His shot! Oh boy! He whistled that wide, not by much. On the short side, on the glove side, of goaltender Laurie. Oh, he can fire that puck. Play still in the Flint zone. Here's Giannetti trying to get Gardner. Gardner, oh, trying to hit Chason, who was cutting to the net, knocked away from him. Good job by Van Drunen to get it over and hold it in. A shot by Chason! High in the slot, and he fired that one wide. Chason getting some chances. Now here comes the Generals back. Whittle lost control of the puck. Comes into the Saginaw zone. Van Drunen now with it. He put it right on the stick that time of Nemirovsky. And Murawski in across the line. O'Brien snapped the shot, saved by DeLorme, and he covers up on it as the puck got away from him. And Mark DeLorme coming up big, kicking that one out, and quickly pouncing on the loose puck. 4,307 on hand here tonight watching a dandy of a hockey game. Saginaw won, and Flint nothing. On the face-off, back on the point. A shot that time by Mike Bondi. Never got through, hit a skate, goes wide. And the gears elect just to slow the puck down ice. Racing back after it, Mike Bondi. Osborne trying to step into him. Bondi avoids the check. Play along the near board. Trying to knock down by Francois Sassaville, but it's whistled down a hand pass in the offensive zone. As Francois Sassaville knocked it down with his glove hand and went right to teammate Brian Steiner. And the linesman right there blows the play dead. 13:27 left here in the second period. Face off outside the Flint zone. Francois Sassaville to take the draw against Corey Ignis of Flint. On the draw, back to center. Rifled in by Rick McDonald. Oh, that came right out in front. Now in turn, trying to clear back to center, a move and across the line, Ignis, his shot, fired that way wide, comes off the boards, held in by Mike Bondi at the point.
Comes in behind the goal, now in the left corner. Corey Ignis trying to get it off to Ambrosiak. Wilson in there, takes it in behind the Saginaw goal. Goes into the corner, trying to come out in the slot. Being tied up by Sasseville. Wilson still comes up with it. His pass went in behind Mike Bondy, and it slides back into the Flint end. Now Beadle backhands it quickly back to center ice. Peter Ambrosiak on the left side to Nemirovsky. Broken up right at the line by Joe Smazin. It's whistled down on the offsides as Flint got ahead of the play. 12:46 left here in the second period. Saginaw 1, Flint nothing. Let's pause for this. This is Saginaw Gears Hockey on Sports Talk Radio.
I didn't get all those penalties.
Well, back to play. Back in the Flint zone. They battle up in the corner. Back on the point. Mueller. Taps it around the boards. Loose puck. Now Mark Colicut put it on the stick of Giannetti. Out in front, here's Justin Morrison. Goes to the left corner, gives it on off to Dominic Chiasson, back on the point to Patrick Charbonneau. His shot right on, loose puck out in front. Cleared away by goaltender Rob Laurie at the last moment. Justin Morrison, he lost his balance, fell down. Nemirovsky picks it up, starts back. Headman's a puck up the socket, comes back in the Saginaw zone, but ridden off the play, and Mueller quickly turns back up ice. Gives it off to Giannetti, rolls off his stick, being chased by Justin Morrison. He couldn't get to it. Reynolds trying to clear. Jumped over the stick of Francois Sasseville. Comes back to center. Van Drunen. And now it's whistled down on the offside. Well, it was Dwayne Ward and Jesse Grenier. We're both giving 5 minutes for fighting and game misconduct at the 4:05 mark. In case you're keeping score. And also at the 4:05 mark, Jeremy Fladovnik and Trevor Bremner were both given 5 minutes for fighting. Out of town scoreboard. The Champion Mortgage out of town scoreboard. Well, looking at it, it's Port Huron 6 and Thunder Bay 1. And Asheville leading Quad City 5-0 in the second period. Now in across the line. Bondi trying to snap it out in front. Captain Osborne lost control of it. Play still deep in the gear zone. And now in turn. Osborne up on the right side and across the line, Gardner. Gardner being wrapped up by O'Brien, being held by O'Brien. And the referee, George Harrison, has his hand up as he caught that one in the gears. Go back on the power play. Oh, that time Joel Gardner trying to cut the net. He was all wrapped up, couldn't get loose. So 8:56, the time of this penalty. And so the Gears will go back on the power play. Greg O'Brien goes off for holding at 8:56. And here's the Gears on the power play. Van Druden down to Francois Sasseville, broken up, and Ambrosiak able to clear the zone. And the Gears go back. Van Druden in behind his goal. 10:45 left in the second. Gears 1, Flint nothing. Gears on the power play. Sackett breaks it up. Backhands it deeper into the gear zone. Mueller picks it up, goes in behind his goal. Now pass up on the left side. Francois Sasseville gives it to Osborne, who rifles it in, comes high off the glass. Who took a strange bounce, come right out in front. That was a break for Flint. As it went right on the stick of Steve Beadle, who cleared the zone. Now Mueller. Fires it right back into the Saginaw end. Into the Flint end. Now in turn, right out in front. Oh, that's right, Gardner. Totally clearing attempt by the goaltender. Oh, and he missed it. Now a bouncing puck. Gardner picks it up in the corner. Put it on the stick of Mike Bondy. Trying to clear it. Jumps over the stick and in turn, Beadle. His pass goes right behind him, man, but it comes back to center and in turn. Sackett just throws it down ice. Ryan Mueller back. 45 seconds left of the power play for the Gears. 9:45 left here in the second. Play right at the Flint blue line, broken up. Whittle racing after it. He's knocked off stride, falls to the ice, and Gloin comes out, clears it back to center. Now here comes the Gears back. Morrison in across the line, and it's whistled out on the outside as Mark Gianetti just got ahead of the play. The Gears trying to get it into the Flint zone, slow it down and set it up. Rob Laurie. I'll tell you what, Saginaw so far, they outshot Flint in that first period, 8-6, and I think they're out shooting them here in the second period. Well, Joel Gardner, center of the line with Justin Morrison on the right side, Mark Gianetti on left, Rick McDonald and Patrick Charbonneau paired together on defense on the faceoff, comes back deep in the Flint zone, but the Generals are able to clear it. Going back after it, Rick McDonald. McDonald picks the puck up, goes in behind his goal, pulls up, brings it out himself on the left side of the goal. His pass up to Gianetti at center. Another Morrison. Morrison banks it off the boards, goes right to goaltender Rob Laurie, and he elects to drop down and cover up, not taking any chances. And that'll allow the faceoff to take place deep in the Flint zone, but only 6 seconds left in the penalty to Craig O'Brien. 9:10 left here in the second period. Dominic Chason with a goal and two assists so far on the season, and getting his first goal in the Gears uniform here tonight.
On the draw, puck into the corner. Knocked away from Steiner. Now in turn, Nemirovsky picks it up. He's turned around. Trying to clear it is Corey Ignis. He stepped in too. Both teams are back to full strength. Steiner picks it up, but it's whistled out on the offsides. And with 8:54, left here in the second period, 1-0 in favor of the Saginaw Gears. Let's pause for this. This is Saginaw Gears Hockey on Sports Talk Radio. Well, 8:25 left here in the second period. Play back in the Flint zone. Steiner steps into his man. And Nemirovsky comes up with a way out in front of his own net. Just knocked it away from Captain Keith Osborne. Puck slides back to the Saginaw and Jamie Hayden. Over with Nemirovsky. Loose play at center. Now Beadle fires it back in and knocked down by Keith Osborne. And the play goes right on. I thought he hit that with the raised above the crossbar. Now in turn, Flint fires it back deep into the Saginaw end. DeLore knocks it down behind his goal. Jamie Hayden up the center to Osborne. Keith Osborne in across the line. Boyd the check still has it over to Francois Sassaville. Rolls the goaltender, Laurie. He banks it off the boards, held in by Charbonneau. His shot! Oh, that time Laurie just got a piece of it. Now in turn, here's Wilson. Starts back up ice, and we got a penalty forthcoming in behind the play. And I think it's Mark Collicutt. It's going off for the Flint Generals, and it is. Well, that happened in behind the play. And referee George Harrison right there, and Mark Collicutt will go to the box. 12:27, the time of this penalty. Well, 2 minutes for Ruffy. The Gears are 0-3 so far on the power play tonight with 5 shots during those 3 power plays. Boy, if they could get a power play goal here and get another goal. They lead 1-0 as Dominic Chason getting the goal here in this the second period. Now Van Drunen at his own blue line. Being watched by Ambrosiak. Is it the Mueller? Got away from him. And in turn, it's cleared back down ice by Rakushkin. And Junin, he stepped into by Androsiak deep in the Saginaw end, but the gears start back up ice. Now Dominique Chiasson, stick handles in across the line.
Going around his man, poke checked off his stick by Sackett, picked up by Mueller.
Ryan Mueller along the right wing board.
Cross ice pass, collected off the stick of Sackett, but held in. Mueller on the right point. To Van Junin, his shot, tipped loose out in front, still loose away. And they whack at it, and Rob Horry trying to reach for it. The puck is still bouncing around. And now the referee, George Harrison, blows the play dead.
As Rob Horry lost his goal stick, and he's kind of wondering, looking at referee George Harrison. But I tell you what, the puck was still loose. And Harrison, Rick, Johnny on the spot, could still see it. A minute 11 left in the power play. For the Saginaw Gears, 6:44. Left here to play in this, the second period. The home opener for the Saginaw Gears, 4,307.
On hand here at the Saginaw Civic Center, the Winlow Arena watching this game.
Sasseville against Whittle on the faceoff. Whittle wins the draw, lays in there, comes back on the point to Mueller though. Mueller on the left point to the right point to Van Drunen.
Down into the corner. Chiasson put it right on the stick that time, a beetle bouncing play along the mirror boards. Van Drunen had it knocked away from him. Now Whittle picks it up and starts back up ice, shorthanded.
Jeff Whittle in the cross line, his shot! Oh, that time to Lorne. Had a piece of it, and I think that stunned him.
And we've got the play whistled down.
Now, interference is the call by referee George Harrison, and it's coming against the Saginaw Gears. There was still 47 seconds left in the penalty. Mark Collicutt of Flint, and now Dave Van Drunen goes off for interference. 13:40 the time of this penalty, and so we play 4-on-4 hockey for the next 47 seconds, and then the Flint Generals will have a power play. They're 0-for-1 so far on the night. Faceoff will take place back in the Saginaw zone. Off to the right of goaltender Mark DeLorme. Well, DeLorme got a little delay here, taking a drink of water, keeping the Saginaw in. Off to the right of goaltender DeLorme. McDonald picks it up, goes in behind his goal, comes out on the left side, straight in front of his net. Slowly up out of his own zone, 4-on-4 hockey. Puck is dumped in,
goes into the right corner, racing after it. Giannetti steps into his man out in front. Joel Garner couldn't knock it down. Now here's Jeff Whittle down the left wing.
Whittle in across the line. O'Brien cutting it. Whittle shot right on. And DeLorme came out and cut the angle down and holds on to that one. 24 seconds left in the penalty to Mark Collicutt of Flint. A minute 37 left in the penalty to Dave Van Drunen. Saginaw 0-for-3 on the power play tonight. Went 0-for-1, and very shortly, within 24 seconds, they will have their second power play. But so far, the Gears are doing a great job, not allowing very many quality scoring chances by the Flint Generals. Sackick in the left corner, trying to center it, knocked down. Wilson giving a rough ride by Mueller. Sackick picks it up, throws it out front. Here's Bondi's shot, that's deflected. Loose play out in front, and Mark DeLorme diving for it, but he's got help from Joel Gardner. Gardner back to center, trying to go around Bondi. Bondi's got a hold of his stick.
I don't believe that one. Mueller keeps it in the left point, though.
Oh, Bondi had a hold of his stick. Morrison gives Bondi a rough ride. Now Beadle starts back up ice as the Flint Generals are on the power play. Saki over to Beadle. He turns at the right point, tries to slow things down, walks in. Gives it off to Saki, a shot that went wide.
Loose play along the near board. Being chased down by Patrick Charbonneau, comes out in front, and Joel Gardner,
Johnny on the spot, finds an opening, clears it down ice.
45 seconds left in the penalty to Dave Van Drunen.
Now Sackick up on the right side. Mike Bondi pulls up, throws it down in the corner. Ambrosiak races after Wilson there. Jumped by Joe Smazel. Smazel tries to bump him down into the corner. Back to Wilson. Wilson's shot never got through. And in turn, Joe Smazel whacking at it. And a Gears are able to clear back to center, and the Generals bring it back in on the offside. 4:40 left here in the second period. 1-0 in favor of the Gears. Scott's this period favors Saginaw 6-5. Saginaw outshot the Flint Generals 8-4 in that first period. So far, the only goal coming here in the second period at the 3:20 mark off the stick of Dominic Chason. Face off outside the Gears zone. Beadle at center ice over to Mike Bondi. On the right side, Nemorowski fires it in. DeLorme trying to knock it down, lets it go into the corner. Clearing attempt by Joe Smuzza. That jumps off the boards and comes back deep into the Flint end. Osborne in there for checking. Goaltender Laurie played it away from him. Now here's Beadle. That mans a puck up to Corey Ignis. Sidesteps the check from Van Druden. Backhands it deep into the Saginaw end. DeLorme knocks it down behind his goal. Jamie Hayden. Now on up to Keith Osborne. Both teams are back to full strength. Smuzza in across the line. His shot right on Laurie. Taps that one and drops down and covers up, not allowing a rebound. Well, Saginaw 0-3 on the power play, Flint 0-2. And the faceoff forthcoming into the Flint zone. Off to the left of goaltender Rob Laurie. Brian Steiner center of the line with Dominic Chason on the left wing. Mark Giannetti on the right side. Mueller, Charbonneau back in the point.
Coming back, and Ross Wilson
had it taken off his stick by Mark Giannetti, and Giannetti threw it down ice. And with 2:43 left here in the second period, it'll bring a faceoff back deep in the Saginaw end. Off to the left of goaltender Mark DeLorme. 1-0 in favor of the Saginaw Gears. On the draw, back on the point. Mike Bondi throws it in the left wing corner. Now picked up by McDonald, gets it back to center. Here's Justin Morrison in the cross line, being hooked off the play. Morrison shot out, he fired that wide on the stick side. Smuzza keeps it in. The Gardner in behind the goal. Back, trying to get it back to Morrison, broken up by Mike Bondi. The battle in the corner, Morrison picks it up for the gear. Bottom of the near board, back to Joel Gardner. Gardner had it knocked away from him. Back on the point, McDonald steps up. Knocked Ambrosia off the puck, but it comes back into the gear zone. Now in turn, here comes a Saginaw Gears trying to come up out of their own end. Joel Gardner at center. Gardner, his pass, trying to get it to Morrison, broken up. Play at center ice. Rick McDonald banks it off the board into the Flint end. 1:45 left here in the second period. Gardner couldn't keep it in, comes back to center, but he plays the puck. Trying to get over to Rick McDonald, he's knocked down. Now Nemorowski in across the line to the right side, he snapped the shot, never got through. And Chason picks it up. Now back down the left wing. And across the line, Bremner's shot right on. And Rob Laurie makes a save. Oh, and Trevor Bremner got a stick up on the face. And Bremner looks over at referee George Harrison. And no penalty is called, and the play is whistled down as the puck goes up on a play with 1:25 left here. And this is the second period. Now face off will see where it'll take place. Deep in the Flint zone, off to the right of goaltender Rob Laurie. Francois Sasseville, center to line with Dominic Chason on the right side. Captain Keith Osborne on the left. Brian Mueller, Patrick Charbonneau paired together back on the point. Oh, we got a close one here, folks. Asseville against Jeff Whittle on the draw. Now we got a false start. That time Mark Collicutt. Now in turn, Sasseville comes out of there. Dominic Chason, rather, will take the face off. Jeff Whittle's way back in there. Now Keith Osborne, I don't know what he's hollering about. He's hollering something to referee George Harrison. He's probably wondering why Francois Sasseville was tossed out of there and not Jeff Whittle. And I'll tell you what, Keith Osborne made the point and Whittle is tossed out of the faceoff circle. On the draw, Generals control. Mark Collicutt in behind his goal for the general. And Nemorowski, cross ice pass, comes back to center O'Brien. He's knocked down by Patrick Charbonneau, and we got a penalty for it coming. I don't believe that one. Patrick Charbonneau just stepped up and knocked the punt player down. And Patrick Charbonneau heads to the box. Oh, well. Now the third power play of this hockey game for Flint. Well, 2 minutes for interference is the call against Patrick Charbonneau. Zero shots. This is the third power play for the Flint Generals. They have not yet four shots. And this is their third power play. 18:48, the time of the penalty. Well, the Generals on the power play, puck fired deep into the gear zone, kept in the point by Mike Bondi. Nito whacks at it, that along the rear board. Sackett down to the corner to Ambrosiak, back to Sackett. Had it knocked away from him by Osborne. Generals still control. Here's Sackett, trying to get it back on the point. Nice job, broken up that time by Captain Keith Osborne. Slowly rags it into the Flint zone. Now in turn, Sasseville throws it in behind the Flint goal. 40 seconds left in the period. Now Ambrosiak tried to get it over to Ross Wilson. Play comes back into the Saginaw end. And Drunen, he backhands the puck back to the Flint blue line, where it's played by Steve Beadle.
Beadle, his pass intercepted at center. And in turn, Osborne fires it back deep in the Flint zone, giving the chance for the Gears to send out some fresh leg. Trevor Bremner and Justin Morrison out there as the two forward.
Dave Van Druden, Jamie Hayden has the two defensemen on this penalty killing unit. And Morosky in across the line. Morosky at the top of the right circle. Snap the shot right on door, makes the save. And covers up on a rebound. And the horn sounds to end the second period as Mark DeLorn came up big with a save there and covered up on the rebound. Well, after 40 minutes of play, it's Saginaw 1, Flint nothing. We'll be back to take a look at that second period for you. But first, let's pause for this. This is Saginaw Gears Hockey on Sports Talk Radio.
We're going back to tradition.
Come on, bring it up!
I'm a big traditionalist, especially when it comes to hockey.
You can't turn the puck over there, forwards. You get that puck in.
I'm a player's coach in the essence where, you know, I believe you got to pat somebody on the back.
Go, five guys. Attaboy, Sass.
But if somebody needs a quick, swift kick in the rear end, they're going
to
get it.
But one of you guys has to recognize, got to see the other guy going. You both can't be going. Come on, do your job.
Camarada Bremner, Benlin and Zale, you guys decide who's going to start there, and you four rotate. The way things have gone here the last, you know, 2-3 years on the ice, it's just unacceptable for the city of Saginaw. So we're here, we're back, and we're going to put on a product that the fans of Saginaw can be proud of, and more importantly, be a contending hockey club for a championship. So it is imperative for the Saginaw Gears to be not only a winning hockey club, A, for the Saginaw Gears and the fans of Saginaw, but B, for the players themselves. You know, they've got to win, they've got to produce, and if that happens, doors are going to open for them.
Yeah, if you're the inside guy, you got to go. Stein should have been back. Keep going.
So, you know, there's good times, there's bad times, but through it all, if guys come together and stick together, you know, 9 times out of 10, you're going to have a great hockey club.
Rocco, you don't make that play here in the neutral zone. You get it in. Bates. Bates. Joey does it right and does the fucking hard run. You know where the puck's going. Get there. Come on now. Get on your horse. Move it. That's it. Shoot the puck. Shoot the puck.
Talent means a lot, but more importantly to me as an ex-player and as now as a coach, the character of a player. I believe, you know, the character of any person is the utmost, and I look for that in my players. If I have a choice between a talented player or a less talented player with more character, 9 times out of 10 I'm going to take the character player, or I should say 10 times out of 10, because come playoff time, come crunch time, come, you know,
last minute of a hockey game, you want your character players out there. It's not necessarily the team with the most talent that wins a championship. It's the team with more, with the most character, and that's what I believe in.
50 goal scorer would have had that one in the net. Nice.
I hope that we are competitive. We are a hard-working hockey club. If we can do that on and off the ice, I think it's going to be a great 98-99 season.
Bremner, McCready, Steiner, Bremner, McCready, Steiner, Charbonneau, your mule.
Are back, and we have their game of the week right here on QTV every Sunday at 5 p.m. Tune in and check it out. Crazy fans, they want to check out the game, they need to tune in to QTV Sundays at 5, eh?
Must be a 7 o'clock game.
Hello, hockey fans. Bill Corbier on the set of In the Crease, bringing you the excitement of Saginaw Gears hockey all season long. Join me and head coach Robert Dirk as we highlight hard-checking, fast-paced action of the Saginaw Gears hockey team. Check out your favorite plays from the Gears games, as well as in-depth looks at the team and organization behind the scenes. That's In the Crease with me, your host Bill Corbier, and head coach Robert Dirk. Sundays at 4:30 on QTV, Delta College Quality Television.
George Harrison at center ice. Ready to drop the puck.
Third period action underway. Generals on the power play for another 42 seconds. Now Beadle, his pass up on the right side, now in across the line. Bondy throws it in behind the net to lure him out of his goal. Played away from Ambrosiak, who was tied up nicely by Van Drunen. And the Gears are able to slide the puck back down ice into the Flint zone, forcing the Generals back on their power play. Opening seconds of the third period. Saginaw 1, Flint nothing. Third game of the season for the Saginaw Gears. Now here is Beadle out in front of his goal. Pass up on the near boards to Mike Bondy. Down the right wing and across the line. Pulls up top of the circle, snapped a shot. Knocked down by Jamie Hayden. A great job by Hayden.
Gears
the center. And the penalty's expired to Patrick Charbonneau. Both teams are back to full strength. Now Jeff Whittle, he's turned around. Here comes the Generals across the line. Snap the shot that went wide on the short side. That time by Craig O'Brien. And the puck comes off the boards back to center, fired back in. Generals have to get back onside. Jamie Hayden now with it. Hayden, his pass up to center to Giannetti. Knocked off the puck by Mark Colicutt. Now in turn, Greg Kushkin fires it back into the Saginaw end. Joe Smaza. Up on the right side to Chase Sonda. Giannetti knocked off his stick by Craig O'Brien. Now Gardner stepped into by Colicutt. Giannetti in across the line. Throws it right on to goaltender Laurie, who steers it into the corner. Giannetti in there for a checking. Now Van Drunen on the point. Oh, comes back to center, but Gardner has it for the Gears. Now Mark Giannetti rifles it in as the Gears start to make a line change. Bremner comes off the bench, so does Justin Morrison. Play at center, here's Joel Gardner. He lost it, but Morrison picks it up and across the line. Drop pass for Gardner. Gardner in a slot, still has it. Trying to get the shot away, oh, and he couldn't pull the trigger. Kind of got away from him. Now the Generals start back. Nemirovsky ridden off the puck nicely by Van Drunen. Now Bremner, clearly on the stick of Whittle, centering attempt knocked down, and the Gears start back up high. Here's Joel Gardner. Gardner across the line, trying to stick a handle around his man. Him and Nemirovsky battle on the near boards. Gardner throws it out front, knocks loose, comes in behind the Flint goal. 17:30 left here in the third. Saginaw 1, Flint nothing. Whittle brings it in across the Flint line, stepped in two by Brian Steiner. Knocked down. Whittle gives him a shot back. Whittle now punches Brian Steiner right in front of the referee. Brian Steiner and Jeff Whittle. Oh, and left hand, another right hand by Steiner. And Whittle getting some punches in, but Steiner. Steiner has his jersey pulled over. Oh, Brian Steiner got a couple of good shots in there.
Well, I'll tell you what, it all started along the far boards when Jeff Willow right away threw a punch into the face of Brian Steiner right in front of the referee. They came back near center ice and they both dropped the sticks and gloves and they'll both go to the penalty box. And it should both be 5 minutes for fighting. And Jeff Willow and Brian Steiner. So we've had a few fights in this game. Not too surprising, eh? Now the face off, top of the circle.
Saginaw zone. Sasseville on the dog in second along the near board.
Osborne back ends up back to center.
Mike Bondy rifles it back in. Got away from Mark DeLorme in the corner. Charbonneau race after. Sacky got in front. Ambrosiak trying to get over to Wilson, broken up. Now the gears trying to pick it up ice. They had it knocked off their stick. Comes back deep into the corner. Mueller up on the right side. During the attempt, knocked down as Justin Morrison tried to clear it. Geno was putting some pressure on. High in the slot. Back at the point. Bondy shot. Oh, that went wide, came off the backboard. Oh, that was close.
Play in the corner, Peter Ambrosiak. Stepped in through by Francois Sasseville. Back kick held up by Mueller. The puck comes out in front, and goaltender Mark DeLorme just drops down and covers up. 16:35 left here in the third. Saginaw 1, 4-0. Let's pause for this. This is Saginaw Gears Hockey on Sports Talk Radio.
Well, 6:19 left here in the third. Play back in the Saginaw end. Bounced off the boards by Corey Ignis. Going back after Jamie Hayden in his own end. Pass off the right wing boards. Comes back to center. Now in turn, Corey Ignis fires it back in. Jamie Hayden has it. Too far out in front of Dominique Chiasson. Comes back in the Flint end. Mark Collicutt played it away from an on-rushing Giannetti. Play back into the Saginaw end. Here's Gardner. Jumped over his stick. A little sloppy play right now. Now the play at center, and it's whistled down a hand pass called the Flint General.
15:49. Left here in the third.
Dominique Chiasson getting the only goal so far in this hockey game. We got a close one. Big crowd on hand, 4,307. Join a dandy of a hockey game. Saginaw right back in action this Friday right here at the Civic Center as they'll take on the BC Icemen. Well, the face-off will stay into the Flint zone with 15:44 left to play here in the third period.
Francois Sasseville, center near line for the Keith Osborne on the left side, Justin Morrison on the right, Brian Mueller, and Patrick Charbonneau paired together back on the points. On the draw, the General's control. Mike Bondy behind his goal, banks it off the boards, back to center. Mueller backhands it, and that deflects off the glass, side from the crowd and out of play. Another souvenir. With 15:35 left here. A close one. Saginaw and Flint played three preseason games. Saginaw winning the first one by a score of 3-0 and losing both times at the IMA. On the draw comes back to center. Here's Beadle. Beadle played away from Sasseville, broken up by Mueller. Mueller rushing after it. Osborne in across the line. Sasseville snapped the shot.
Oh, and he didn't miss much on that one. Oh, he got a lot of wood on it. Now here comes the General's back. Sakic had his skates pulled out from under him, and when it's touched by Justin Morrison, referee George Harrison has his hand up. and Justin Morrison heads to the box. 2 minutes for tripping. And so the Flint Generals go back on the power play. Now so far in the faceoff department, Flint winning in that category 27-17. And the faceoff deep in the Saginaw zone, off to the left, the goaltender Mark DeLorme. On a draw goes right to goaltender DeLorme, who wisely drops down and covers up on it. Justin Morrison in the box. 2 minutes for tripping, 15-14 left here in the third. Francois Sasseville, who's seen a lot of ice time here tonight. Robert Dirk using Francois Sasseville a lot. Sacky on the draw. Beadle, the right point, his shot deflects off his stick, lands on the backside of the net. Sacky got a front shot by Wilson, a save by Mark DeLorme. Oh, Ross Wilson. And Mark DeLorme standing tall. 1:48 left in the power play for the Generals. Francois Sasseville, Keith Osborne, the two forwards out there. Patrick Charbonneau and Brian Mueller, the two defensemen on this penalty killing unit for the Gears. Now doing some switching out there, back and forth as Robert Dirk trying to direct where he wants his players to be on this important faceoff. On the draw, lays right in the circle, back in the point to Beadle. Down in the corner, the Sacking snapped the shot, that hit his own player. Sacking picks it up again along the right wing board. Back on the point now, Beadle's shot, that goes wide. Kept it in the left point though by Mike Bondy. Sacking in the left corner, comes out in the left circle, back to Beadle, and a nice defensive play by Francois Sasseville, falling down. Whacks that puck back to center ice. Now Mike Bondy in across the line, gives it out off to Ambrosiak. Try to send it out front to Sacking. Sacking goes past, one in behind Ross Wilson. On the right point to Beadle. Throws it down low, DeLorme. Locker save, goes into the corner. Now comes back in the point, Beadle. Waits a check, his shot, that went way wide. Bounces that in front, loose, and it's knocked away from Peter Ambrosiak. And now Joel Gardner comes back up ice. He's being hooked on the arm. Play goes on, and Van Druden picks up the loose puck and fires it back into the Flint end. Now Mike Bondy rifles it in. That came off the boards, funny. Along the near boards and in turn, cleared down ice by Jamie Hayden. Rob Laurie gives it on off. Now here's Nemirovsky. On the near boards, Mike Bondy and across the Saginaw blue line, trying to cut to the net, snap the shot. That went way wide. Racing after it, held in by Craig O'Brien. O'Brien in the corner to Nemirovsky. Being watched by Van Druden. Now back out in front to Corey Ignis. Back in the point. Bondy shot. That whistled wide and high. Held in. Now Gardner trying to get a stick on it. They battle on the near boards. Held in by Corey Ignis to Nemirovsky. Now Ignis picks it up in the right corner. Tried to send it out in front. Gardner's there. He couldn't clear. Held in by Mike Bondy. His shot knocked down. Deflects off a stick. And over the glass and out of play. And here we go. Mikhail Nemirovsky and Jamie Hayden pushing in one another. And the linesmen quickly get in between. Well, both teams are back to full strength. And as the Saginaw Gears kill off another penalty. 13:15 left here in the third. Saginaw 1, Flint nothing. Let's pause for this. This is Saginaw Gears Hockey on Sports Talk Radio. Now 13 minutes left here in the third period. Here comes the Gears in across the line. Dominic Chason stepped in too, gets it in behind the Flint goal. Justin Morrison ran out in the slot, knocked away. Now Nemirovsky starts back up for the Generals. Nemirovsky in across the line. Joe Smuss, a shot right out, and DeLorme made the save. Another shot, and DeLorme got a stick on that one, deflects it into the corner. Shot off the side of the goal. Loose out in front.
And Smaza picks it up, banks it off the boards, and a net comes off its moorings
as a Flint player goes crashing into it, namely Corey Ignis. And we get a whistle with 12:35 left here in the third period. And the linesman comes over, puts the net back on its moorings. Well, these same two teams got 13 more meetings on the regular season. Sacking against Francois Sassaville. Puck lays there and is cleared by the Gears as it slides back deep into the Flint zone. Rob Laurie leaves it in behind his goal. Now Beadle. Ed mans a puck up to Ambrosiak up on the right side. Here's Mike Bondi in across the line. Bondi pulls up, throws it at the side of the net. Gorm wraps it around the boards up on the right side. Osborne trying to clear it. That hit Beadle, and Osborne picks it up once again. Brian Mueller on the near board. Mueller over to Patrick Charbonneau, quickly up out of his own zone, in across the line. Rips a shot, and Laurie got down low on that one, deflected it away from the goal. Held in by Sassaville, his shot knocked down by Steve Beadle, comes back to center. Here's Ross Wilson. Wilson, stick handles, gives it on off, now across the line. Ambrosiak, oh, he whistled that wide as he came across the line. Now Trevor Bremner gives it up to Francois Sassaville. Sassaville and across the line, throws it down deeper in the corner, goes in behind the Flint goal. Giannetti in there. Giannetti trying to check Steve Beadle off the puck. Beadle gets it up on the left side, and the Generals start back up by. Pass by O'Brien, goes astray, comes back deep. The linesman fell down, and he blows the play dead. Icing is the call, as that puck was fired from the Flint side of the center red line. 11:21 left here in the third. Dominic Chase on so far, the only goal in this hockey game in the second period. Well, again, the Saginaw Gears will play host to the BC Icemen this Friday. Game time 7:35. We'll be on the air with our Fabiano Brothers pregame show at 7:20. And the Gears will board the bus and travel to Upper State, New York for two games, Saturday and Sunday. There's a shot by Dominic Chase on, never got through. On the boards, Nemirovsky, a little outlet pass. Now O'Brien trying to ground his man. He stood up at the line by Jamie Hayden. The puck is fired down ice by the Gears. And it's touched up. And icing will be the call as Greg Kushkin gets back for it. And that'll bring the faceoff back deep into the Saginaw zone. Off to the left, the goaltender, Mark DeLorme. Well, Joel Gardner will take the draw against Jeff Whittle of Flint. On a draw, Gardner wins the draw. Hayden stepped into by Whittle, but backhands it over the opposite corner. A little outlet pass broken up by Nemirovsky. Nemirovsky, a centering attempt that goes and knocked away. Still along the left wing boards. Pass right through the goal crease. Pass on the near board. Now Jamie Hayden backhands it. Back to center, knocked down. O'Brien had it played away from him. Here's Giannetti across the line, snapped the shot. That deflects wide, played off the backboards by goaltender Rob Laurie, and he lets the hold on.
4,307, the Gears take you.
They're announcing the attendance here tonight, 4,307. And the faceoff will stay in the Flint zone with 10:37 left on the clock here in the third period. Francois Sassaville starting the line with Keith Osborne on the left side, Mark Giannetti on the right wing, Patrick Charbonneau, Brian Mueller paired together back in the point. On the draw, comes back on the right point to Mueller. Mueller fakes the shot, now throws it down low, glove save by Rob Laurie. He saw that one all the way. And he holds on, and again we'll have a face-off. Francois Sassaville on the draw. The puck goes into the right corner. Mike Bondi trying to clear it. His pass knocked down by Justin Morrison. Now Francois Sassaville plays with the opposite corner. And there forechecking Keith Osborne. Trying to knock away out in front of shot. And a save by Rob Laurie. Now Sassaville cutting to the net. set up perfectly. And Laurie had to come up big. Now, Keith Osborne on the right side. Here's Morrison, his shot, save, rebound! And it's cleared away, oh, a big rebound that time. Now here comes the Generals back. Sackett get across the line. Along the right wing board, throws it down low, tip shot knocked away from Ambrosiak. And in turn played around, oh, and it jumped over the stick of Steve Beadle on the point. Ah, break for the Gears, it comes back. Now here's Beadle. Brings it in across the line. That's whistled down on the outsides as Ross Wilson was ahead of the play. 9:40 left here in the third period. Saginaw 1, Flint nothing. As some fresh legs come out for the Saginaw Gears. Now Brian Steiner. Center aligned with Dominic Chason on the right side and Trevor Bremner on left wing. Rick McDonald. And Joe Smaza back on defense, and the faceoff goes right to goaltender DeLorme. Steers it in behind his goal for Rick Wilson. Banks it off the left wing boards. Bremner stepped in too by Mark Collicutt. The puck comes back into the Flint end. Racing after it, played off the boards. That time by Craig O'Brien. Knocked away, but now O'Brien gets a pass. Comes back up on the left side. Nemorowski, his shot saved by Mark DeLorme. As Mikhail Nemorowski, just inside that left circle, let the shot go, but Mark DeLorme had the angle covered and caught it in the midsection. I tell you what, we got a nail biter here. It's a close one. With 9:17 left in the third. And the faceoff, main deep in the Saginaw end, off to the right of goaltender Mark DeLorme. Well, Justin Morrison will take this draw against Jeff Whittle. Whittle wins the draw, and that time, Greg Kushkin couldn't control it. It comes back to center. Now the Gears trying to start back up ice. Nemorowski, though, brings it right back in. On the right side to Whittle. Whittle cuts to the net, save by DeLorme, and the rebound just went wide.
Oh, that's
fine. DeLorme making a good save right there. Now they jam up in the corner. Oh, big hit by Trevor Bremner. Smaza lost his helmet. He has the puck. Now in turn, Rick McDonald just clears it back to center. Fired right back in by Greg Kushkin. DeLorme settles it down at the side of his net as the Generals are making a line change. And now in turn, it's just cleared down ice by the Gears. Icing will be the call. And Steve Beadle touches up with it. 8:35 left here in the third. Saginaw 1, Flint nothing. Let's pause for this. This is Saginaw Gears Hockey on Sports Talk Radio.
Shots on goal this period are 7-4 Flint.
Well, 8:20 left to play in the Gears zone. Goes in behind the goal. Ross Wilson spun around by Van Gunen. Osborne in there ties his man up. The puck's still loose. They try to kick it loose. Wilson trying to bring it out in front. Kicks it with a skate. Now in turn is picked up by Francois Sassaville. We got a holding call coming up. Oh, my. George Harrison is calling a holding penalty against Saginaw. Now Ross Wilson trying to bring it out in front, and Van Drunen tried to stay with him, tied him up, and Dave Van Drunen goes to the box, 2 minutes for holding. And so the Flint Generals go to the power play, a very important penalty kill now for the Saginaw Gears. 11:53, the time of this penalty to Dave Van Drunen for holding. On the draw, Sakic trying to get it back on a point, comes back to center. Steve Beadle lost control of it. Now he picks it up. Cross ice pass over to Mike Bondi. Bondi had trouble with it. Stick, backhands it deep into the Saginaw end. Here's Wilson. Down to the corner to Ambrosiak. Peter Ambrosiak back into the corner to Sakic. Sakic back on the point. Beadle snaps the shot, knocked out in front. Wilson being tied up. A backhand shot, that goes wide. Oh, that on the short side that time. Sackett to Beadle. Beadle's shot. That hit players out in front. Loose in the high slot. Good job to knock it back. But it's kept into the point. Beadle being watched by
Keith Osborne on a front shot by Wilson, a save
by Mark DeLorme. Oh, great save by Mark DeLorme, dropping down to Rob Roth Wilson. Well, he was right by the hash marks, let the shot go, and Mark DeLorme just quickly dropped down and covers up on it. A minute 14 left in the penalty to Dave Van Drunen. 7:21 left here in the third. Saginaw 1, Flint nothing. Now we got a little delay as goaltender Mark DeLorme does some repairs to his goalie pad. Justin Morrison, Trevor Bremner, the two forwards out there. And Joe Smaza, teamed with Jamie Hayden, two defensemen on this penalty killing unit.
And the Saginaw Gears and look down on the bench, and Robert Dirk talking to his players. Close one, we got a nail biter. 7:21 left, and 1-0 is our score. On the draw, Generals win it. Beetle back in the right point on the near boards. And Nemirovsky, Mikhail Nemirovsky. Down in the corner of the Whittle, back to Nemirovsky on the near boards. Cross ice pass on the left point to Mike Bondy. Snap the shot right on.
Oh, and I don't think Mark DeLorme seen that at first. He hit him right in the stick. And he was able to drop down on it with 59 seconds left. And the penalty to Dave Van Drunen. 7:06 left here in this to third. Face off to the right of goaltender Mark DeLorme. Now Justin Morrison against Sakic on the draw. Comes back on the left point to Mike Bondy. Here's Beetle for the right point. His shot goes wide, come off the backboard. Mazza kicks it with his skate. Mazza in behind to go. Three Flint players back there. Comes loose. Now Wilson had it knocked off his stick. Hayden pushes him down to the ice. Justin Morrison able to pick up the loose puck, slide it in. Here's Bremner trying to cut to the net. Knocked away from him at the last moment by Beetle. Now Mike Bondy comes back and helps out. Now 30 more seconds for the Gears to try to kill off. And across the line, Ambrosiak trying to get it to Wilson. Nice defensive play broken up by Justin Morrison as he quickly got back and clears it back into the Flint end. Now Beetle.
His pass, that time jumped over the stick of Bondy, loose play at center. Beetle plays it off the left wing boards, rifles it in, comes into the corner. Brian Miller trying to tie it up, it's kicked loose. Back on the point to Mike Bondy. Good job by Keith
Osborne, stealing that puck and clearing it all the way down ice, and the
Gears have killed off the Flint power play as Van Drunen goes to the bench. Under 6 minutes left here in regulation. Saginaw 1, Flint nothing. Nemirovsky in across the line. Being watched by Smaza. Throws it around the boards into the corner of the Whittle. Throws it back under the point. Mark Collicott, his shot, that went wide. On the stick side, Brian Steiner trying to clear it out. It took a funny bounce, held in. Out in front, a shot, that goes wide. That time by O'Brien, as he was cutting to the net. Whittle to Nemirovsky, being watched. Smaza tries to tie him up. Mazza knocks Nemirovsky down, the puck is loose. Now in turn, Gardner couldn't clear it, but now here comes the Gears back up ice. Brian Steiner, oh, he voids a check, but the puck gets away from him and comes back into the Flint end. 5:10 left in the third. Now O'Brien throws it right to goaltender Mark DeLorme, steers it on off for Patrick Charbonneau. Good Dominic Chase on the right side, his pass intercepted by Wilson at center. Now in turn, Sakic back across the line. Ambrosiak looking for somewhere to go with it. And it came back to center. Now Bondy played it away from Dominic Chase on. Play at center. Here's Van Drunen. Van Drunen trying to get it back to Gardner. Kept in by Dominic Chase on. Goes in the left corner. Joel Gardner giving a rough ride. By Beetle. They battle. Puck comes loose in the corner. And the play is whistled down.
4:36 left here in the third. Saginaw 1, Flint nothing. Let's pause for this. This is Saginaw Gears Hockey on Sports Talk Radio.
Here's a
And we're back as well with 4:36 left here in the third period. Still that 1-0 score. Dominic Chason getting the goal in the second period to indeed have a nail biter here. Oh boy, I tell you what, the Gears about to get another one. So far, shots on goal in this period favor of the Flint Generals, 7-4. And looking at the champion mortgage out of town scoreboard, final, Port Huron defeats Thunder Bay by a score of 9-1. And the Detroit Red Wings lead the Nashville Predators 4-2 at their end of two. And another out of town score, see Asheville leading Quad City 5-0 in the third period.
Now the Generals fired into the gear zone, but it's whistled down. And that'll bring the faceoff near the center red line.
4:26 left here, the seasoner home opener for the Saginaw Gears. Over 4,300 fans on hand. We had a lengthy pregame show, almost 55 minutes. On the draw, Sasseville wins it. Knocked away, puck lays at the Gears blue line. Banked off the boards by Miller. Now Osborne throws it into the Flint end. Sasseville after it. Laid away from him by Steve Beadle. Up to Ross Wilson. His pass out in front of Ambrosiak. Ambrosiak stepped into at center ice. By Justin Morrison, who backhands it into the Flint end. Cleared right back out. Wilson put it right on the stick to Brian Miller. Miller throws it deep in the Flint end as the Saginaw Gears and the Flint Generals both make wholesale changes. Now here's Van Drunen stepping up on the play. Throws it in the Flint end, but Beadle picks it up. Beadle. Is it on off to Ross Wilson, back to Whittle, out in front of him. Whittle chases it down in the right wing corner, try to center it. Here's Ross Wilson being tied up by Dave Van Drunen. Joel Gardner in the help out. Whittle had it knocked away out in front. Wilson knocked down and the net's knocked over. Almost on top of goaltender Mark Delorme. And that causes a stoppage of play by referee George Harrison. That's the time a goaltender quickly wants to get out of the way.
3:27 left here in the third. Faceoff stays deep into the Saginaw end as Joel Gardner will take the draw against Jeff Whittle of Flint. Now Giannetti comes out, has a few words of advice for Joel Gardner. Gardner, Giannetti, and Dominic Chason, the forward line. On a faceoff, the puck comes off the boards, back to center. Comes back deep into the Flint end, racing after it, Dominic Chason. Chason in the corner, trying to get it to Giannetti, who's tied up, knocked down at the side of the goal. Giannetti gets up. Puck comes loose, and after Joel Gardner. Gardner now, lost control of it, played in the corner. Now by Greg Kushkin, gets it back to center. Dave Van Drunen has to wait for his teammate to come back onside. Joel Gardner, but didn't wait long enough. And the offside is called with 3:02 left here in the third. Well, the Gears will play 4 games in 5 nights, counting this game here tonight. They have a day off tomorrow. They'll play host to the BC Icemen on Friday, and then Saturday travel up to Upper State New York to Binghamton to take on the BC Icemen in a home-and-home series, and then Sunday conclude their road trip in the game against the Mohawk Valley Brawler. Well, out-of-town score, Asheville 7, Quad City 4, with 17 minutes left in the third. That's our champion mortgage out-of-town scoreboard. Now, Puck jumps over the stick to Francois Sasseville. Play at center, comes back into the gear zone. Sasseville quickly gets it back up to center ice. Justin Morrison gets it in the Flint end. Now the General's trying to come back up. Sackick, ridden off the play by Sasseville. Wilson brings it in across the line, trying to chase it down, but it's whistled down on the outside.
As a linesman, Johnny on the spot with 2:33 left here in regulation. Saginaw 1, Flint nothing.
Well, Francois Sasseville out there to take the draw again. Robert Dirk using him a lot tonight. Osborne and Justin Morrison as the wingers, and the faceoff comes back to center. Morrison picks it up, flips it high, bounces into the Flint end. Keith Osborne trying to get it down the corner. Snow bounces around. Osborne picks it up in the left corner. Keith Osborne being tied up by Mike Bondi. Trying to come over with Sassaville. We got four players in there still trying to kick it loose. Sassaville trying to get it back to Osborne. Now in turn, picked up by Beadle. He just clears it back to center. And in turn, Osborne throws it back in the Flint end. Mike Bondi banks it off the board. Now in turn, Corey Ignis, who has not seen much playing time here in the third, throws it in the Saginaw end. Van Druden banks it off the right wing boards, back into the Flint end. A minute 45 left here. And this is the third period. Saginaw 1, Flint nothing. Yeah, it's like playoff hockey. Here's Mike, O'Brien in across the line, but broken up nicely. That time by Mark Giannetti, who clears the zone. Now Corey Ignis at center, trying to get around his man, Jimmy Hayden, brings it in. There's a shot right out by O'Brien. And a save by DeLorme, and the rebound is cleared as it was bouncing up here. Here's Dominic Chiasson, cutting it out. He's being hooked out of the play. There's a penalty forthcoming. Oh, yeah, lovely. Oh, Dominic Chiasson was breaking up ice. And I'll tell you what, with a minute 16, oh, he had to call that one. Flint a little upset with a call as Mikhail Nemirovsky goes to the box. Oh, he had that stick right around the midsection of Dominic Chiasson, who was cutting to the net. And so the Saginaw Gears go to the power play. Well, 18:44, time of the hooking call against Nemirovsky. And on the draw, the Generals able to clear the zone. A minute 10 left in the regulation. Now in turn, here's the Gears trying to come up out of the way and played off the right wing board. Sassaville and across the line going, that snapped the shot. That went wide on the short side. Mueller holds it in though. Mueller on the left point. Down deep in the corner, Sassaville throws it on the slot. Whittle picks it up. Boy, you gotta watch him. Oh, nice play that time by Dominic Chiasson. Chiasson to Sassaville. His shot saved by Rob Laurie as he got that pad down. 38 seconds left in regulation. Gears on the power play. They lead 1-0 on the goal by Dominic Chiasson. Oh, all the players up on the bench watching this close one. 25 seconds left. Ryan Mueller wraps it around the board. Bondi trying to keep it in. Now Rob Laurie comes to the bench for an extra attacker. The goal is empty. A shot right on. Loose high in the slot. Knocked away. Still has it. Ross Wilson tied up nicely by Osborne. Now Joel Gardner backhands it. Sackett trying to chase it down. Being watched by Patrick Charbonneau. Gardner trying to get it out. 3 seconds. Two. Puck into the corner. And the horn. Generals 1-0 as Mark DeLorme gets his first shutout for the Saginaw Gears. Oh my, I tell you, great action at the end, and the 4,000 plus fans are on their feet as the Saginaw Gears have defeated the Flint Generals by a score of 1-0. And this hockey game is over with, a close one as the Saginaw Gears defeat the Flint Generals in their home opener by a score of 1-0. In that first period, no scoring. And the Saginaw Gears out shooting Flint 8-4 in that first period. 4 penalties for 11 minutes against the Gears. 4 penalties for 19 minutes against the Flint Generals. The Gears 0-2 on the power play in the first period and Flint 0-1. Well, the only goal in this hockey game coming in the second period as Dominic Chiasson gets his first goal in a Saginaw Gears uniform. Joel Gardner, Mark DeLorme, the goaltender, draw the assist, time of the goal, 3 minutes, 20 seconds into that second period, an even strength goal. And so the Saginaw Gears get their first win of the season, and they now have a record of 1-2, and something they very much needed, especially before a home crowd of over 4,300 fans, and the Saginaw Gears hold on and win this hockey game by a score of 1-0 as Dominic Chiasson gets the only goal.
You and I have talked about it before. He's strong defensively. And then with the, you always said that there's this kid by DeLorme. He's going to win you a hockey game every once in a while when it's going to be 1-0. Tonight you didn't have that offense, but you got the good goaltender.
Well, I've said it from day one. Mark DeLorme's going to win us a game here and there. He's going to, and he's going to carry us to, as far as we're going to jump on his back. He's going to carry us to the promised land. He's got the credentials. He's an all-star in this league before, in other leagues. As he goes, we're going to go. And you saw it here in the third period. He didn't get a lot of action in the first two periods. The team played great sound defense in all three zones. Come the third, Flint came out, guns a-barreling, and Marcus, he's the wall. That's why he's the best.